Okay, when we got interrupted by the Discover Oman meeting, we were talking about the angular speed of the wheel. So I had written on the board angular speed, and after some confusion we agreed on what the angular speed would be. So Nick said that it looked like it was rotating about 210 degrees per second. So you could say the angular speed is 210 degrees per second. You could say the angular speed is 7 pi over 6 radian per second. You could even give the angular speed in terms of how many revolutions per second. Since 180 degrees is half of a revolution, and you could think of it as a full revolution, as 30 degrees is what, 1/12 of a revolution, like 30 out of 360 is 1/12. So 210 degrees would be 7/12 of a revolution. You could say that also. You could say 7/12 revolutions per second. And again, that's coming from 210 degrees. If you cut a circle into 30 degree parts, there'd be 12 of them. And 210 degrees is 7 of those 12 parts. So if a wheel rotates 210 degrees, that's 7/12 of a complete revolution. Those are all angular speeds. So what they're going to ask you for is a linear speed. And a linear speed would just be distance per unit of time. And so we talked about the most common type of linear speed would be like, how fast was that wheel turning in kilometers per hour? And so we just estimated and said probably around 5 kilometers per hour. If I'm just walking next to the car, I'm probably walking about 5 kilometers per hour. So how would we figure this out? Well, we do exactly what we've been practicing in class, right? If the wheel is rotating 210 degrees, that's why we've been saying these statements of, if I rotate the wheel 210 degrees, I will have traveled a distance of 7 pi over 6 lengths of the radius. Now remember, we measured it, and the radius on the wheel that I have is about 32 centimeters. And so if you say, what's the linear speed? It's very simple. If you say 210 degrees, or I will have traveled a distance of 7 pi over 6 lengths of the radius. So I need to take 7 pi over 6 and multiply it by the length of the radius. Right? About 3.7 on our estimation. The 7 pi over 6 is about 3.6, 3.7. 7 pi over 6 is 3.66 lengths of the radius, so multiplied by 32. That's a distance of 117.29, approximately 117.29 centimeters per second, which is exactly what we've been saying. If a wheel rotates 210 degrees in 1 second, I will have traveled a distance of 7 pi over 6 lengths of the radius in that time period. So now it's nothing more than unit conversion. Convert centimeters per second into kilometers per hour. So I showed this before. This is what I'm expecting to see. 117.29 centimeters over 1 second. And I'm converting that into kilometers per hour. So I don't want seconds, I want hours. So I'll have seconds up in the numerator, and I'll have hours in the denominator, and I'll say there are 3,600 seconds, 60 times 60, in 1 hour. So this will cancel out, and I'd have centimeters per hour. I don't want centimeters per hour, I want kilometers per hour. So I have centimeters down here. And some of you would be better off probably saying that, like, in 1 meter, there are 100 centimeters, and then saying in 1 kilometer, there are 1,000 meters. Now, you could just say there are 100,000 centimeters in 1 kilometer and be done with it, But people tend to either forget that or make mistakes, so maybe it's better to go from centimeters to meters and then meters to kilometers. So now you would have kilometers per hour. So all you have to do is multiply across the top, take the exact value, multiplied by 3600 times 1 times 1, and then it would get divided by the 100 multiplied by the 1000. That's why there's 100,000 centimeters in a kilometer. And there's how fast we're going. We're going, that wheel, 4.22 kilometers per 1 hour, which made sense because we guessed we were going about 5 kilometers an hour, 4.22 kilometers an hour. The other thing they'll do, and students tend to get flustered by this, is they'll switch it around and they'll say, if you were going 120 kilometers per hour, they'll say, how many revolutions would that be of the wheel per second, or some unit of time? That's just working backwards. If it's the same wheel, which is about the size of a tire on a vehicle, and you say, hey, we're cruising along at 120 kilometers per hour, how many times is this wheel spinning per second? And so in class, I would have tried to get you to visualize this, and I would have spun the wheel as fast as I could and say, how many times is it going around per second? And you guys would have said, probably 4 or 5. Like, I can get this wheel in class to spin about 5 times per second. It's as fast as I can get it to go by hand. So you say, what would it be if you're going 120 kilometers per hour? How many times will the wheel be turning per second? You're just working backwards. Since you're trying to figure out revolutions per second, and you know the radius is in centimeters, what you want to do is convert 120 kilometers per hour into centimeters per second. It won't always be centimeters per second, but if they're asking how many revolutions per second and my radius is in terms of centimeters, then I'm going to convert kilometers per hour into centimeters per second. So that'd be the same process. I would say 120 kilometers in 1 hour. I don't want kilometers per hour, I want centimeters per second. So I'm going to get rid of the hour and say there are 3,600 seconds in that hour. So now that'd be kilometers per second. Then I don't want kilometers, I want centimeters. So in 1 kilometer, there are 100,000 centimeters. So now I multiply across the top, I multiply across the bottom. I'm basically taking 120 times 100,000. And it's getting divided by 3,600. 3,333.3 repeating. 3,333.3 repeating centimeters per 1 second. So the next time you see the speed limit and you see that it says 120 kilometers per hour, you could say to yourself, ah, the speed limit is 3,333.3 repeating centimeters per second. Same thing. But since our radius is 32 centimeters, now visualize this. Here's the circle, here's the wheel, and this is 32 centimeters. You want to know how many times this thing has to spin per second to be going this distance. So let's figure out how many centimeters you go when it spins once, right? Let's figure out for 1 revolution, we want to know how many centimeters would you travel in distance. So that's easy enough. 360 degrees equals 2 pi lengths of the radius. So if I take 2 pi lengths of the radius, 2 pi times 32, so I'll take my calculator, 2 pi times 32, I get about 201.06 centimeters per revolution. I haven't said any time here. I just said if it turns once, this is the distance I'll go per one revolution. So to be going 120, you need to be going more than 201.06 centimeters per second. You need to be going 3,333.3 repeating centimeters per second. So now it's time for some high-tech division. Yes, division. I need to see how many times this wheel needs to turn in this 1 second time period to cover this distance, when I know that one spin or one revolution is 201 and I need to go like 3,000. So, division. I need to be going 3,333.3 repeating centimeters, and I know that every time the wheel spins once, I go about 201.06 centimeters. So I'll use actual values. I will take on my calculator 3,333.333333333 divided by the actual value there, the actual 2 pi times 32. I get approximately 16.58. This is 16.58 approximately. What is it telling me? It's telling me that this wheel has to spin approximately 16.58 times every second in order to be going 120 kilometers per hour. That's kind of scary, actually. When you're driving along on that highway and you're going just 120, that wheel, that tire, is spinning 16 and a half times every second as you're cruising along. That's why it's a big deal when you blow a tire, because you had a lot of revolutions going there every second. So you would say 120 kilometers per 1 hour is equal to 16.58 revolutions in 1 second. That's what we were trying to figure out. How many revolutions a second to be going 120 kilometers per hour. This is easy. They give you an angular speed. You can easily figure out the distance that you've covered in that amount of time, and then it's nothing more than conversion, converting it to what they want. This one is a little more difficult. How many revolutions in a certain time period? Change the linear speed into the same units that your radius is and the unit of time they're asking. Like if they said how many revolutions per minute, then you would have converted kilometers per hour into centimeters per minute. Or if they would have said whatever the radius is in, you do that same number of units per the unit of time. Then you figure out how much distance you would go in one revolution, because you know to go this distance you need to spin more than once. So how many times does it need to spin? Division. 16.58 revolutions a second. Based off that explanation, that's what would have happened in that last 15 minutes of class. You should be able to do the problems that I post on Moodle and ask you to complete. If you have questions, please come see me, even though nobody rarely ever comes to see me with questions. Bye-bye.